Hi Pisces, I'm here for another reading for you today. As always, it is a general and timeless reading. It's not a personal reading, so just take what resonates with you and leave what doesn't for the next person. And if you would like a personal reading, a one-on-one personal session, or Akashic Records, you can go to 144bluerosetemple.com or you can email me. And as always, thank you for your love, thank you for your support. If my energy and my readings resonate with you, feel free to subscribe and click on that notification bell so you can know when the next reading does come out. Now we are going live tonight, so feel free to stay tuned as well. We're going to be picking out the free tarot giveaway winner. Divine Mother and Father, Holy Spirit of God, for Pisces energy today. For Pisces energy, what do we have for the Pisces? Bottom of the deck is prophecy over here. I love this message already. It's my favorite card in the deck. Returning home. Love, humility, respect, healing the earth, transition, life between lifetimes, and loving welcome. I'm going to grab a few more cards before I start channeling. Why do we have returning home and healing the earth for Pisces today? Why do we have returning home and healing the earth? Pisces, some of you are experiencing, now there are two different things, soul walk-in and soul retrieval. But a soul walk-in or soul retrieval here, Hecate or Baba Yaga may resonate with you. What is one more message for Pisces for returning home, healing the earth, past life healing, and patience? Bottom of the deck is timeout, solitude. And we do have patience there. Pisces, you are going through some deep past life healing. It says energy field adjustment, aura cleansing, and health. Some of you can be guided to cleanse your energetic field in whatever way it is that resonates with you as far as spiritual cleansing right over here. But what I'm really seeing too is you're having this returning home, Pisces, to who it is that you've always been. All right, like beyond the conditioning, beyond what I'm seeing is deep past life healing, actually, with patience and Hecate, past life healing, okay? You are going to be living a very different life, Pisces, either soon or just in the future, 222, as soon as I say that, than you're living right now, okay? And then the name Gustavo may even resonate with you, and it's just interesting because it proves that it's 3:33 p.m. on the clock because he messaged me at 3:33 p.m. just now. So the that name may resonate with you. Also, the number 333 may resonate with you as well. That could be a sign that this reading is for you. Healing the earth, love, humility, and respect. Like Pisces, you bring such light to this world. There's also just some part of you that either needs to recognize this or maybe you need to hear it. Like, look at this over here, and then this. It's almost like that's how God, you know, that's how you reincarnated here. It was through these, like, infinite hands of creation and just sprinkle, dusted upon the earth, okay? Some of you are wondering, like, why am I here? Why am I here? What is my life purpose? It even feels a little bit frustrating. So for some of you, you've been going through very deep past life healing so that you can live, you know, your fullest embodiment, your most authentic embodiment, and so that you can both manifest and live and experience your dream life. I'm getting a lot here about your reincarnation, okay? Number one, you know exactly why it is that you're here. You're just remembering or returning home. All right. For some of you, I do feel like spirit is revealing to you some of your life purpose. Why is it that you're here? Number one, your life purpose is to be happy. And then after that, you get a calling. We do have Isis that came out over here. Divine Mother and Father, Holy Spirit of God, for the Pisces energy. Why do we have patience, past life healing, healing the earth, and returning home? I know Isis came out again. We have release fear here. Secret admirer. Ascension. Isis, okay? So Isis may definitely resonate with you, or even her comedic name, Osset. We do have ascension. You're going through an ascension. You have a secret admirer, okay? So you may be going through whatever it is that you're going through. You don't even realize that someone's actually watching you go through all of this and is really admiring. What I'm getting is like your spirit through all of this, your humility, your love, okay? Like someone is falling in love. With you, but it's interesting because it's in the midst of like you going through some deep healing, but it's like they're admiring your spirit through it all. Okay. And I mean, you're here to be a light worker. You are here to anchor your love and your light to this earth. You know, you're here to help bring harmony, peace, and balance and healing to this earth, to restore Ma'at, that harmony and that balance. That is why it is that you are here. All right. And for some of you, I do feel like there's either maybe you're going through a Saturn return or solar return would actually be more for like that Leo Virgo energy. Maybe you are a Leo Virgo, you know, sun, but you're having some sort of return here. So it could be a Saturn return in general. This is you returning home to self. And with this past life healing that you're going through, I'm getting a lot of soul retrieval. A lot of soul gifts are also being retrieved from other lifetimes, especially your healing gifts. For some of you, your healing gifts, I'm getting Blu-ray starseed. It could also be Venus, so like a Venusian starseed, or even Sirius, the galaxy of Sirius, all of that blue energy, or Orion. You are here to share these very powerful, I'm also getting like intelligent healing techniques that you have. Even the Arcturians may resonate with you. I'm just all that blue energy. Your healing abilities in a past life are going to be just as strong in this lifetime. And you're here to share that. There's also just this random message coming through that I'm even getting a little bit of the energy of Sarah Lakali, which they say, just that they say it, Sarah was the daughter of both Yeshua and Mary Magdalene, but not everyone was able to see and to experience, say, her healing, you know? And so what's also coming through is not that you work in secret, you're hidden in plain sight, okay? Five of Pentacles over here. You are hidden in plain sight, and not everyone may see or even know the wisdom that you hold, these beautiful soul gifts that you hold. That's what I'm getting, is it's almost like a little bit of like a secret, you know, or hidden in plain sight, okay? But I do see something very, very beautiful coming in for you. You're going through a big cleansing, past life purification, but it brings in something very beautiful. Now, why do we have the Five of Pentacles for Pisces here? You're being very protected. For some of you, if you're going through anything with finances, I actually think it's more past life. Okay, you're healing past life wounds with finances. We have the Ten of Cups here. Why the Five of Pentacles? This is past life, yes. More Pentacles energy. So for some of you, now Akashic Records, you could go on YouTube and you can access the Akashic Records yourself. You could always go to someone for support or for help, because we do, you know, we could sometimes see the blind spots in one another. However, this is something that you can do on your own. Why the Four of Coins here? So again, those of you who are experiencing financial difficulties, that's past life energy. And you really can find the root of whatever that is yourself. Again, going in the Akashic Records, accessing your quantum wealth energetic field, which you can all do. Maybe call upon your dragon spirit guides to help you with this as well. Why the Seven of Wands? You have Nine of Wands, and then you do have the Death card. Okay, it's like you were meant to go through this divine transformation. Okay, with the Nine of Wands and the Death card. I see this also as keep going, even in the midst of you feeling. And what I do feel like that this is doing for you is creating some sort of big death and rebirth. Okay, but again, with that, I get the soul retrieval. What also comes to mind with Nine of Wands and the Death card is the shamanic death. And if you go on Google and look it up, which actually that makes sense with this auric, the energetic field adjustment card here. So if you study shamanism, the shamanic death is basically like a death and just pulling out from your entire auric field, cellular, like all of you, what doesn't resonate, you know, the parts of you that come from trauma, the negative energy, all of that. And it feels like an ego death, okay? But this is actually meant to cleanse your energetic field. You know, it feels that way, and it's a death of the ego, but it's meant to for you to be reborn into this new energy. Some of you may be going through some sort of season or cycle in life where like you are going through this death and rebirth. But I do feel like it is meant, again, for you to have this rebirth. This is actually a gift from spirit, and not, it's past life. This is very multidimensional what you're going through. You know, so even if it's something like money issues, relationship issues, whatever it is, it's not just about this lifetime. It definitely has some sort of past life influence. Now, why the death card with the Nine of Wands and Seven of Wands? You have judgment. Why judgment here? You're meant for so much more, Pisces. Like, you're really meant for so much more. And it's interesting because you have the Nine of Pentacles here, Ace of Cups. So I see that at one point you were making good money. You know, you were happy in whatever it is that you do, whatever it is. And I do see you going through some sort of Job season. But when it comes to the energy of Job or the story of Job, it was given back to Job. And I have chills as I say that. And 144 as I say that too. It was given back to Job, everything that he lost, and it was multiplied. And it makes me want to cry because what I'm seeing here, Pisces, for you is like, yes, in your reality, you're experiencing a lot of loss. You're experiencing financial difficulties. This is meant, though, to kill your ego. This is meant for you to, consciousness-wise, go through a big death and rebirth. Detach from those material things. But what I'm seeing is, yes, it's death and rebirth. You're very protected through it. God's judgment, and it feels like God upon your life. God is going to bring not only restoration, but also vindication, Pisces. This is meant to transform you as a person because you're going to be blessed with even more. You went from the Knight of Pentacles. Okay, great. You're independently wealthy. But you're meant to be the King or Queen of Pentacles. All right? Three of Pentacles with the Queen of Pentacles over here. So this is actually God's judgment upon your life. God is preparing you so that when this comes in, when this abundance comes in, when for some of you, you're going to be upgraded, whether it's in your fight, for some of you, higher financial tax brackets, maybe in work or this or that. In general, you're being upgraded. But the past cannot come with you. And so it's like, you know, there was this destruction energy, but understanding how destruction works, right? It's only meant to have, and how do I word this? It's all like your consciousness. It's like God wants you to look at money a different way, to look at life a different way, to look at you a different way, that these things do not define you, who it is that you are or this or that, because it's going to come back and it's actually going to come back multiplied 100%. It's prophecy with that prophecy card. It's going to happen for you, Pisces. And that's why the patience card is there. Those past life soul lessons, because it's all energy. And this is the year of Saturn. So those past life soul lessons regarding money or this or that, you're clearing it out, but it's a gift for you because you're going to, and you know the term where it's like the last one has the last laugh? You're going to laugh for a long time, you know, with this Three of Pentacles and Queen of Pentacles energy. Why the Three of Pentacles and Queen of Pentacles? Why the Three of Pentacles with the Queen of Pentacles? Yes, you're releasing past life burdens. Four of Wands over here, celebration. Ten of Wands, Ace of Pentacles, okay? They're definitely, and again, I'm seeing this more on Akashic Records level, soul contracts, and past life energy. This has nothing to do with this lifetime. You, on a cellular level, past life level, you are releasing those burdens that no longer resonate with you, the weight, the blockages that no longer resonate with you so that you can receive this. Why Ten of Wands with the Ace of Pentacles? What is this Five of Swords? Things that were holding you back from that victory, Pisces, okay? Because you have the Six of Wands here. You have the Five of Swords here. Why Five of Swords with the Six of Wands? Yes, and I really do feel like even if things happened without of you, say like in this lifetime, someone took your money or this or that, that was only meant to come back around from past life energy for you to alchemize that soul lesson because it was holding you back actually from that victory and success that you're really meant for, Nine of Cups. All right, now what's the advice for Pisces in this reading? You're getting ready to see something you've never seen, Pisces. And that's what I was saying. It's interesting that I mentioned Ma'at in this reading because we have justice and the scales. Okay, so the scales are going to be balanced over here. And that is what it feels like is happening. The scales are balancing for you, Pisces. All right. If you've experienced a loss, then there shall be a balance where you gain that back and then some. All right. You have Justice and the King of Pentacles. Regarding finances, regarding abundance or your career, Pisces, you are experiencing vindication and restoration right now in your life. You know, there's a song called Sekhmet by Lava, and it says, "Seated at the feet of Ma'at, the lioness stands proud, protecting the throne and the crown. Justice and balance is all around, and abundance reigns now." Okay, and so for some of you, even Ma'at or Sekhmet may resonate with you, but justice and balance surrounds you, and abundance reigns now in your life, Pisces, and that's what's coming through. All right, and it's coming through, maybe not in your timing, but in the perfect divine timing. This is a very multidimensional reading. It was a lot of past life. Look at that confirmation. Past life confirmation again, you know, healing it is that you've been going through. For some of you, this is ancestrally, when it comes to your ancestors of poverty, of lack, of this, of that, ancestral spirit, connect to your lineage. A family wound or pattern can be healed now. Maybe in your ancestral lineage, they have experienced a lot of poverty or this or that. A part of that healing is even releasing the consciousness or on a cellular level, that energy it is or that traumas, maybe regarding finances and money that you hold on to with the white eagle. So the white eagle may resonate with you. I do also feel like this can be very ancestral as well as past life. We also have Saint Germain, which is the violet flame. So for some of you, the violet flame may actually assist you in healing and cleansing this energy too. You could call upon the violet flame. Karma releasing. Move beyond drama, create your own path, and make room for good energy. And that's what you're doing, is this energy, these old stories regarding money and this and that, that are maybe yours, past life. For some of you, this is also your ancestors. It's not yours to carry, especially with that Ten of Wands energy and Ace of Pentacles. You're releasing that past life, say karma or lessons, to make room for all of this beautiful and good energy. I'm going to grab one more card of advice. Again, if you'd like a personal reading, one-on-one personal session, or Akashic Records, you could go to 144bluerosetemple.com. What do we have for advice for Pisces? Thoth may also resonate with you. A lot of Egyptian energy. Ma'at, Sekhmet, and Thoth. Which Ma'at is the counterpart of Thoth as well. All right. We do have Life Force energy. No more hiding. Earth magic. And rest, okay? So definitely rest, you know, for those of you who have been putting out your intentions, manifesting, it is coming in. Believe in yourself. Thought may resonate with you. When it comes to money, and I have High Priest of Atlantis that just came out too. So also just to focus on the masculine energy, which material realm stuff, that is masculine energy, whether you're male or female. You know, trust in your magic, trust in all those intentions it is that you put out there. No more hiding. I do feel like a lot of clarity is coming in for you, and there is a message to rest, okay? That's what I have for you, Pisces. I hope that it resonates. I'm sending you so much love and so many blessings to your day.